So let's dig a little deeper into what we mean by the happened before relationship. And I'm going to denote the happened before relationship with this arrow. A happened before B. That's what this notation means. What this notation is implying is one of two things. Either A and B are events in the same process, which means given our belief that a process is sequential, A must have happened before B. If it is a textual order, A is here and B is here, then A must have happened before B. And that's one possibility. Or if we are asserting that A happened before B, and A and B are not events on the same process, but A is an event in one process, B is an event in a different process, then there must be a communication event that connects A and B. In other words, if A is a communication event of a message, and B is a receipt of that same message, then A happened before B, where A is the send of that message, and B is the receipt of the message. So this is the implication of saying that an event in a distributed system, A, happened before B. And these events can be anywhere in the system. Anywhere in the system, an event could be happening A, and another event could be happening B. And if we are asserting that A happened before B, what we are implying is one of these two possibilities. One is that A and B are events in the same process, or A is the act of sending a message, and B is the act of receiving a message, the same message, on a different node of the distributed system. The other property of the happen before relationship is that it is transitive. What I mean by that is if we are asserting that there is an event A that happened before B, and this event B happened before C, the implication is this relationship is transitive, and therefore A happened before C. So that's the transitivity of the happen before relationship. Now that I've introduced to you the happen before relationship, it is time for another fun quiz.